Hello, my YouTube friends. My name is Demóclis Rocha, and in this video, I will present to you an addition of fractions that have different denominators. The fractions we have here are 7 over 10 and 14 over 15. The denominators of these two fractions are 10 and 15. These denominators are different. How do we add these fractions that have different denominators? The first step is to calculate the LCM, least common multiple, of 10 and 15. The LCM will be the common denominator of two new fractions that will be equivalent to these two fractions that we have here. So let's get started by calculating the LCM of 10 and 15. We write 10, use a comma just to separate it from the 15. We draw a vertical line on the right, as you can see. And we will start calculating the LCM by doing what we call simultaneous prime factorization. How do we start? We test the divisibility of these numbers by prime numbers, 2, 3, 5, 7. We start with 2 if some of the numbers we have is divisible by 2. If any of these two numbers is divisible by 2, we write the result of the division below the number. If it is not divisible, we just repeat the number. Since 10 is divisible by 2, and 10 divided by 2 equals 5, because 2 times 5 equals 10, we write 5 below 10. Since 15 is not divisible by 2, we just repeat it. Now we have the numbers 5 and 15. Clearly, none of them are divisible by 2. But 15 is divisible by 3, that is the next prime number. What is the result of 15 divided by 3? 5. 15 divided by 3 equals 5. Very well. But 5 is not divisible by 3, so we will repeat this first 5. 15 divided by 3 equals 5, so we write 5 below 15. Moving on. Now we have the numbers 5 and 5. They are not divisible by 2. They are not divisible by 3. 5 is a prime number. It has only two natural divisors, 1 and 5 itself. So in order to continue the simultaneous factorization, rewrite 5 in the right column. What do we get now? 5 divided by 5 equals 1, right? So we write 1 below the first 5 and 1 below this other 5. This part of the algorithm is over. Why? Because whenever we get the number 1 at the bottom of the left columns, this part of the algorithm is over. So what do we do now? Now we just multiply the numbers we have on the right column. Let's do this. 2 times 3 equals 6. Keep 6 in mind. 6 times 5 equals 230. So our LCM is 30. The least common multiple of 10 and 15 is 30. Why did we calculate the LCM of 10 and 15? 30 is going to be the new denominator of two new fractions that will be equivalent to the fractions we have. So now we write two new fractions with 30 as their denominators. Great, but what are the new numerators? Good question. The new numerators are not very hard to find. Think with me. The 10 from the first fraction became a 30. It means that it was multiplied by 3. If you didn't understand it that way, you can just ask yourself, what is the result of 30 divided by 10 is 3. It's the same thing. 10 times 3 equals 30. So what is going to be the new numerator of the equivalent fraction? You just multiply 7 times 3 and get 21. That's how it works. To get an equivalent fraction, you multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same number. So we can say that 7 over 10 is a fraction equivalent to 21 over 30. Now, we do the same thing to get a fraction that is equivalent to 14 over 15, but has 30 as its denominator. 15, in order to become 30, was multiplied by 2. That's right. 15 times 2 equals 30. If it is easier for you, you can just think that 30 divided by 15 equals 2. So, if the 15 was multiplied by 2, the 14 is also going to be multiplied by 2. So we can find the new numerator. Great. What is 14 times 2? 14 times 2 equals 28. What does it all mean? It means that 14 over 15 is a fraction equivalent to 28 over 30. That's right. What is the advantage of getting two new fractions equivalent to the old ones, but that have the same denominator? The advantage is that adding or subtracting fractions that have the same denominator is very easy. We just repeat the denominator, in this case it is 30, and add or subtract, if that's the case, the denominators. So what we do here is add 21 and 28. 21 plus 28 equals to 49. Great. What can we say about the fraction 49 over 30? We can say that 7 over 10 plus 14 over 15 equals to 49 over 30. What else can we say? Is 49 over 30 a proper or improper fraction? It is an improper fraction, since its numerator is greater than its denominator. Can this fraction still be reduced? No. This fraction is already reduced, since its numerator and denominator have no common factors. 7 over 10 plus 14 over 15 equals to 49 over 30. I hope this video was useful to you. If this video was useful to you, please give us a thumbs up. Leave a comment with your opinion about this video below. I'll see you next time. Bye!